Okay, we're going to try again one more time. But I think before I get into Paticca-samuppada again, I want you to take a look at something. I want you to go back in the previous episodes of this series and look at the comments. And there's something very striking about these comments. Not a single one is about Paticca-samuppada. Nobody is even asking the obvious, superficial questions, what to speak of the deep questions. Nobody is even mentioning it. I don't think it's even mentioned once. And this goes back to the very beginning of this channel, because from the start, from the very, what is it called, foundation series, I'm teaching Paticca-samuppada. And look at the comments there. I re-enabled the comments on those early videos so you can check it out. There are no comments about Paticca-samuppada. No questions whatsoever. As if it doesn't exist. Now you see why I'm getting frustrated? You see why I'm starting to think that you guys have some kind of mental block? Because you do. Paticca-samuppada is the core structure, the ontological structure of the Buddha's teaching. Everything else comes in around it. So, if you really want to understand the Buddha's teaching, you have to understand it. He says, whoever sees Paticca-samuppada sees the Dhamma. Whoever sees the Dhamma sees Paticca-samuppada. But even that fellow who went to some retreat with a monk on the West Coast and says that he teaches dependent arising or dependent origination in every retreat, even he didn't answer or ask any question about it. See, this is why when Ananda went to the Buddha and said, you know, this dependent arising is just so clear. It's so obvious. It's omnipresent. It's in everything. The Buddha said, no, no, don't talk like that. Don't speak like that, because this is the most difficult, subtle, and most misunderstood phenomenon. In fact, when the Buddha first became enlightened, he was meditating on Paticca-samuppada. And he was thinking, oh man, how is anybody ever going to understand this? See? So this is not easy. I know it's not easy, but at least give it a try, huh? Run it through your brain. Think it through. With ignorance as a condition, sankhara arise. Okay, you hear that. Now you should sit down and look inside yourself. Try to see this part of yourself. This ignorance. What is ignorance? Remember, it's threefold ignorance. Desire, hatred, and delusion. So look at the fact that you desire to exist. You desire to be an individual. You desire to manifest in the world. Or like Steve Jobs said, make a dent in the universe. Huh? Look at your hatred. Look at how you hate death. Look at how you hate to lose anything. Isn't it? And then look at your delusion, that you think you're an individual. Whereas actually, there is one seamless and completely integrated whole. Just look at it. Don't try to do anything about it. But look at it and admit, yes, I am ignorant. This ignorance is going on, and because of ignorance, then sankhara arise. I'm going to do this, I'm going to become that, I'm going to go here and there, and I'm going to get this, and I'm going to have that, and I'm going to be this, and so on, and unlimitedly. This is the contents of the mind. And then because of those sankhara, consciousness arises, conditioned consciousness. And then because of that, the six senses, and so on. Sit down, look in yourself, observe it in yourself, see it in yourself. And if you have a question, post it in the comments. I will not anymore allow off-topic comments. So make a comment, not, oh, you're such a great teacher, isn't that lovely, isn't that wonderful, oh, great. No, it's bullshit. If I was a great teacher and you were a great student, you would be posting questions about the topic. No flattery, no praise, no kowtowing, no touching the feet or whatever. Huh? I don't need that. I don't want that. I don't want you to be dependent and weak. I want you to be strong and independent, founded on nothing but your own strength, your own will to attain enlightenment. So that's why I chastise you sometimes, because you're lazy. You have a mental block and you won't do the work to overcome it. So I'm not interested in lazy people. So here again, I'm going to read a sutta on dependent arising. I'm going to read the whole Natumha Sutta. Now the Natumha Sutta is from the Samyutta Nikaya, the connected discourses. And this is part of the connected discourses on causation. And Natumha means not yours. The Buddha said at Savatthī, Bhikkhus, this body is not yours, nor does it belong to others. It is old kamma to be seen as generated and fashioned by volition, as something to be felt. Therein, Bhikkhus, the instructed noble disciple attends carefully and closely to dependent arising itself. Thus, when this exists, this comes to be. With the arising of this, this arises. When this does not exist, this does not arise. With the cessation of this, this ceases. That is, with ignorance as condition, sankhara arise. With sankhara as condition, consciousness arises. With consciousness as condition, name and form arise. With name and form as condition, the six sense spheres arise. With the six sense spheres as condition, contact arises. With contact as condition, feeling arises. With feeling as condition, craving arises. With craving as condition, grasping arises. With grasping as condition, becoming arises. With becoming as condition, birth arises. With birth as condition arise decay and death, sorrow, lamentation, pain, grief, and despair. Such is the arising of this entire mass of suffering. But with the remainderless fading away and cessation of ignorance comes cessation of sankhara. With cessation of sankhara comes cessation of consciousness. With cessation of consciousness comes cessation of name and form. With cessation of name and form comes cessation of the six sense spheres. With cessation of the six sense spheres comes cessation of contact. With cessation of contact comes cessation of feeling. With cessation of feeling comes cessation of craving. With cessation of craving comes cessation of grasping. With cessation of grasping comes cessation of becoming. With cessation of becoming comes cessation of birth. With cessation of birth, decay and death, sorrow, lamentation, pain, grief, and despair cease. Such is the cessation of this whole mass of suffering. So this is the secret. This is the key. This is how you attain Nibbana. This is how you attain Buddhahood. This is how you get free. This is how you get liberation. This is how you end the suffering. Don't you want to know how to do this? Why don't you ask? It boggles my mind. Honestly, I just can't understand it. Because the first time I heard about Paticca-samuppada, I said, oh, wow, this is it. I immediately packed up and got on a plane for Thailand to go learn it. And you guys, you don't even want to look the words up in the dictionary. You don't even want to go and read the suttas in the original. You don't even want to go in a monastery and sit and meditate on it, even for a short time. What to speak of enough time to actually realize it. What can I tell you? What can I do? Of course I'm going to be disappointed, huh? But if you look at the comments, well, you can't see all the comments because I deleted a bunch of them. People are trying to psychoanalyze me. People are trying to teach me. Look, even Jnanananda didn't try to teach me. He recognized me. He recognized that I had already attained something, that I was already on the path. I was already in the stream. He simply encouraged me. So what to speak of somebody who can't even recite the 12 links in Paticca-samuppada? You want to teach me? Go fishing, man. Seriously. Get out of town. This is an offense, and because it's an offense, you will suffer. I'm sorry, that's just the way it is. And I've seen it 1,000 times in my 72 years of experience. If you offend somebody, if you disrespect somebody who is high on the path, it's an aparata, it's an offense, and you'll suffer. And it may be, the suffering may be the lack of something, like the lack of understanding of the real secret of Buddhahood, Paticca-samuppada. So look, let's get past this bullshit. Study this stuff. And if you're having a hard time, like somebody posted, the books you posted are too thick for me. No, man, it's your head that's too thick. Do the work, do your homework. Look up the terms in the ordinary dictionary and in the Pali dictionary. Look up the suttas online. The texts are all available. Huh? Don't take my word for what Buddha said. Look it up yourself. Find out for yourself and sit down and look into yourself and find this in yourself. Observe it. Bring it into consciousness. Bring it out of the dark. Bring it out of your denial. And make it aware. That alone will change it. That alone will heal it. That alone will lead to enlightenment. Buddha Sarana.